And he will jump up against Marcus Bolden. And we're underway. Game two on NBA TV in Las Vegas. High lob, Cousins, a beautiful pass. And again, for a bit, the Naz, he'll drive inside. And the bucket and one. Nice finish by Naz Mitrou-Long. Assists against San Antonio.
Well, you can always tell a guy that's been there. And he just plays with ease. He's a probing point guard. He gets in that paint right here. Nice pass.
How about the finish?
Yes, sir.
And T is a big ball up and in.
Yes, great job.
Reportedly adding depth, as NBA teams will do over the next week or so as they fill out rosters. Boy, Naz has by two. Wright-Foreman goes to work to Cousins, toes it up for three. He's got gold shoes on tonight.
Yes, he does. And they're working.
To his former teammate, Bradley, who runs the paint and follows the miss for two. Bradley comes out to help, straddles the three-point line. Just past the six-minute mark. Wright-Foreman, three. Got it.
Nice. They're more apt to make their free throws, but when guys start getting rushed, that's when they start missing free throws. And there he is, shooting that three.
It, being ready to catch that shot, just like he does right here, and not waste a lot of time in getting it off, catching it and shooting in rhythm.
He's not a shoot-first point guard. He's a pass-first, so to be able to shoot that well while being a pass-first point guard is pretty impressive.
Nice move, big fella. Dylan Osetkowski.
He was not looking how he's looking right now. He's really moving and playing well. That was an impressive move.
Zuzman, by the way, on the court for the first time tonight. The Cavs are letting some players who did not see the floor.
Ferrari, your nickname's still the minivan?
You know it, partner. The minivan it is. The minivan it is.
Ferrari. Beautiful. Inside, drives, hangs, hits.
As a player.
Frankie Ferrari, but it's a name you don't forget, that's for sure. Nice
good
play.
Defense.
Oh. Hollins with a wide open lane and puts it home.
Well, the Jazz defense has really been stellar. Even on the shots the Cavs are making, nice timing on the lob there.
Austin Hollins put that ball up on the rim. And there's that pass. There's Fletcher. He'll step back with a left-hand jumper. Good. Just beat the clock.
Yeah, nice patience.
Ball kick picked up. Dribbled off his foot. Zuzman with a bucket.
Yeah, and these coaches like to give opportunity to players to show themselves.
How about Osetkowski? First score tonight for the Big O. There's a drive and a bucket. Fletcher is up and in. What a touch. Osetkowski with a back cut throw inside. Zuzman inside, muscles it up and down.
Deserving of the opportunity to coach at this level. I've gotten to know him over the past few years and just a great man. And he's going to be a great coach for these guys who are willing to be taught.
So Malik with a 7-point half. The Jazz answer back. Austin Hollins with five. Naz goes inside. Jazz fans know that move well. Wright-Foreman gives it away for a three. Oh, big rebound. Coming out of nowhere is Jawan Morgan. Got the ball off, and the three is scored. Cavs, of course, trying to get back to that level after the days of one LeBron James, not once but twice. Naz goes deep for three. Dick.
Where Bradley's improved, but you look at Naz, Mitrou-Long knocked down this three.
And we're tied at 35. Bradley back on the court, draws a double team. Hook shot, two, counted, and he'll be at the line.
With Tony Bradley, this is where he needs to make his bread and butter, right there.
Better that this season, and again, as I look around, this place is... My eyes were shifted for a moment. We'll see a moment ago. It's just a great pass. It starts with McGrew. And then the finish. Oh, my. A little bit of the glitter. But you're right. It's about the love of basketball. Naz is out front on that long pass, and he'll lay it home. Flex for us tonight. Inside. Nice pass. And a bucket by Bradley.
Score is a much better box score, even though the numbers were good last game for Tony.
I do, and it's the way he's getting them, and it's the consistency in which he's getting them.
Kid, one more time, denied. Osetkowski took that ball away from him, feeds it down low, and the bucket by Cleveland. Cousins with a pass to the corner. Rainbow threes up, McCrew with a rebound. Ball's loose, put it up, stays with it, count it, and one. Bradley with a touch. Driving his right, Foreman. Yeah, he'll step back, fires a shot, knocks it home. McCrew drives, gets it back from Fletcher. Plenty of time on that shot clock. Nice spin inside, count it. Those are the ones you love. That ball comes loose off Cousins. Here comes Newman racing inside. The contact's made in the bucket.
He would make sure he wrapped Newman up for this shot and not give him the opportunity for the contest.
So a three-point play for the former Jayhawk of Kansas. Here's McCrew, three, buries it.
Cousins was a 50 in the 50s second round draft pick and has spent 3 years in the G League. He might be ready now to be on an NBA roster. He shot 40% from three.
Got it, that can more or less change your game if you need to.
So to back up what Big T said, that would be by accident when it happens. I think you're exactly right, Bowler. The thing with the post up, one is it's not being used a lot in college, so guys aren't coming with the skill. Be a lot better and do a lot more. Some of it was defensive assignments. Tonight's much more of what you hope to see out of him that makes you feel as though, there's, you know, if needed, he could put in some NBA regular season minutes.
Yeah, it's been fun to watch them on the defensive end. I know a lot of times we like the exciting offensive end, but they've really been able to defense right there by Morgan as Dylan Windler came down the lane. Morgan went straight up in the air to avoid the foul call.
How about the long left hand of Fletcher?
For those who missed it earlier, report today that former Cleveland Cavalier on their championship team.
Naz across midcourt against Hollins. Nice little slip pass inside, bucket good.
You're going to have to help me out, Bowler. I think he gets concussed or something, and then because the Jazz need a player, he ends up getting released, and his college roommate, George Niang, then takes his spot on the roster.
Protecting the paint defensively, I think that's one of the big reasons why he's back in there right now. But also...
Oh, big shot. Wright-Foreman with a breakout. He's scoring a collegiate player a year ago, and that is a beautiful shot using high glass for two.
Well, he's good at it. To mess around with it. If he has a good shot, take it. If not, kick it out so the Jazz can get a three. Right there.
How about that? One tap, make it two for a bucket. KK, you have more with Tony. Wright-Foreman on a drive. Kick out, Fletcher. Three balls up and good.
Nice job by Wright-Foreman.
Wright-Foreman off to McCrew.
Great touch.
You know, at T again, Lawrence gave him some body. Tanner McCrew goes 250, and he's got 10 tonight off the bench.
Well, McCrew counted that with some body of his own and was able to use a strong body to get a soft shot off.
Shot clock at five. McCrew got a mismatch down low. Spins inside off the glass for two more. It's not quite soft enough. Here comes Windler trying to move in on Kidd. Gives the ball up. Cavs with a floater by Lawrence.
Seven rebounds and four assists is a good sign for him, though.
David, I agree. I was just going to say, you know, if you can't get the ball to go down, you continue to do things for your team, and that's what he's done tonight.
No question. Look at them and say, you know, I need to work on that.
Big pass inside. Yeah. McCrew, how he got that ball on the spot.
Just shoot a jump shot, but if he can get decent with that 5 to 10 foot range, Derek Favors type.
McCrew the rebound, and Lamar Skeeter says, let's hold the ball, and the Jazz will win their first game of summer league by 15 over the Cavaliers.